Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you some of the apps that I found most useful on the Fitbit Ionic. So let's get started. The first app that I found quite useful is the Stocks app. So if you tap on this application, you can see here that it shows you the latest price of the share, and you can see here the date when the last refresh was done. And for each share you will see a graph as well, and it shows you whether it's going up or down in price. You can add multiple shares as well, so you can see here that I have Amazon share and Microsoft share. And in order to add a new share, you have to actually do that through the app. So let's see how to do this. So head to your phone and go to the apps section and select the Stocks app and go to settings. And here you can see that I have configured two shares. If I want to create a new one, just type it in here. Let's say it's Apple. So Apple share, and it's added in here. Let's see how's that reflected on the watch. So let's go back, and as you can see here, Microsoft, Amazon, and Apple. And you can see a small graph showing how the stock share is going. So this is the first app that I wanted to show you. The second one is the weather. So the weather app is quite useful if you want to see the current weather quickly on your watch. So you can see here the current address for the watch is showing the current temperature, and if you swipe up, you can see an hourly weather forecast. And if you keep swiping, you'll see the following day's weather as well. And you can actually configure it to show multiple locations. So here I have configured it to show the weather for Sydney as well, in addition to my current location in Melbourne. But if you want to add a new location, you have to do that through the app. So let's see how we can do this. So if I go to the weather app in here and tap on the settings, you can see here the current location and Sydney are configured. I just add a new city. Let's say I want Paris. Paris in France added. Let's see how that looks on the watch. So let's go to the weather again. Yep, so we have current location, we have Sydney, and we have Paris. So the next app that I wanted to show you is the calendar. So if you go here to the watch and tap on the calendar app, you can see here it's showing the days and dates for each week, and with the current date highlighted in red. If you want to move to the next month, you can press the top button. If you want to go back, you press the bottom button here. But that's pretty much it on the calendar app. Not much options on this one. The next app that I want to show you is the alarm, which is quite useful actually. So if you go to the alarms app, you can add a new alarm. let's say 3:49 p.m. You can select whether it's on or off, and you can select which day of the week you want it. So once it's saved, it shows here. If you want, you can quickly make it on or off by tapping on the clock here. If you want to edit it, click on the numbers, and if you want to delete it, you can just tap remove and confirm. The next app that I want to show you is the calculator. Oh, before we move to the calculator, so the alarm can actually vibrate when the time comes. So if you're asleep, for example, and you want to wake up, it's actually quite useful instead of having the alarm on your mobile phone. The next app that I want to show you is the calculator. So we have here this nice app. Very simple, and it shows you the basic operations in addition to the some advanced operations as well if you want. Pretty straightforward and quite simple. The last app that I want to show you is actually how to shut down the watch. So you have to go to settings, about, and you can find here the shutdown option. And this is actually quite useful because if you want to keep the battery live, you can just use this option. Thank you everyone for watching.